In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace and love of God our Father and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My brothers and sisters, to prepare our hearts to enter into the sacred mysteries, let us together call to mind our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. May the glorious intercession of the Virgin and Martyr, St. Lucy, give us new heart, we pray, O Lord, so that we may celebrate her heavenly birthday in this present age, and so behold things eternal. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zephaniah. Thus says the Lord, woe to the city rebellious and polluted, to the tyrannical city. She hears no voice, accepts no correction. In the Lord she has not trusted, to her God she has not drawn near. For then I will change and purify the lips of the peoples, that they all may call upon the name of the Lord, to serve him with one accord. From beyond the rivers of Ethiopia, and as far as the recesses of the north, they shall bring me offerings. On that day, you need not be ashamed of all your deeds, your rebellious actions against me, for then will I remove from your midst the proud braggarts, and you shall no longer exalt yourself on my holy mountain. But I will leave as a remnant in your midst a people humble and lowly, who shall take refuge in the name of the Lord, the remnant of Israel. They shall do no wrong and speak no lies, nor shall there be found in their mouths a deceitful tongue. They shall pasture and couch their flocks with none to disturb them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear me and be glad.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
Look to him that you may be radiant with joy, and your faces may not blush with shame. When the poor one called out, the Lord heard, and from all his distress he saved him.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
The Lord confronts the evildoers to destroy remembrance of them from the earth. When the just cry out, the Lord hears them, and from all their distress he rescues them.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
The Lord is close to the brokenhearted, and those who are crushed in spirit he saves. The Lord redeems the lives of his servants. No one incurs guilt who takes refuge in him.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor. May the Lord be in my heart, my lips, for the burden of the gospel, and all my fathers and Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to the chief priests and the elders of the people, "What is your opinion? A man had two sons. He came to the first and said, 'Son, go out and work in the vineyard today.' The son said in reply, 'I will not,' but afterwards he changed his mind and went. The man came to the other son and gave the same order. He said in reply, 'Yes, sir,' but did not go. Which of the two did his father's will?" They answered, "The first." Jesus said to them, "Amen, I say to you, tax collectors and prostitutes are entering the kingdom of God before you. When John came to you in the way of righteousness, you did not believe him, but the tax collectors and prostitutes did. Yet even when you saw that, you did not later change your minds and believe him. The gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. You missed quite a celebration last night as we gathered and celebrated the feast of Our Lady of Guadalupe, and for me, celebrating La Misa del Español for the first time in 3 años, over 3 years. But there was so much fire and energy in this room that Our Lady of Guadalupe performed a miracle. For the first time in weeks, I did not have to go downstairs this morning and reset the boiler. Now, you might be saying, Father, you just jinxed yourself. Hey, one day's a start. I'll take it. But, you know, it's beautiful being able to celebrate Mass last night for the Latino community in this area. It was amazing. We were expecting maybe 40 to 60 people, and we had 124. It was awesome. And, you know, I always love celebrating Mass for that community because that community is not bound by time. You know, you sit there and go, what time does 7 o'clock Mass start? Well, 7:05. But not only that, we were here over an hour. And I loved it. They didn't complain. Now, if I go over an hour for many of you, you'd run me out of town. But it was so much fun. It was so much fun. They are a community of such tremendous faith. And I loved being able to have that opportunity. And we continue that faith. We continue that faith today as we gather. And we're celebrating the obligatory memorial of St. Lucy, Virgin and Martyr. St. Lucy is the patron saint of those who have eye ailments, because as she was martyred, she had her eyes taken from her, and then she was ultimately stabbed to death. But we turn to her and we ask her for help, especially if we have ailments of the eyes. And so we think about these readings today and continue during Advent and continuing honoring St. Lucy. And turning to the readings, we hear the prophet Zephaniah warns the rebellious city that accepts no correction, foretelling the removal of the braggarts and the protection of the humble remnant. And then in the gospel, we just heard Jesus tells the parable of the father who asks his two sons to work in his vineyard. One son says yes, but does not go, and the other one refuses, but then changes his mind and goes. Advent is certainly a time to return to humility and simplicity. It is a time to examine our hearts and minds with the help of the Holy Spirit to see where we need to change direction. This is a time when we need to make a change in order to heed the Father's voice. You know, I go back to something that I said last night, and I delivered my homily in Spanish and then I delivered it in English because it's the first time I actually attempted a homily in Spanish. And I told them if I mispronounce something, blame Google Translate. But we talk about the first miracle of Our Lady Guadalupe. We often talk about this image, but the first miracle was the roses. One found in December, and second on rocky ground. And as I mentioned last night, you know, we are living in some ways in rocky times. But that shouldn't deter us. That should not deter us away from God. In fact, it's an opportunity, and it's also a lot of potential during this particular Advent as we prepare to Christmas. There's opportunity and potential. And the opportunity and potential is for us, my dear brothers and sisters, to open our hearts to God and to ask him specifically, where do we need to change direction? What attitudes in my heart do I need to change? What opportunities are before us? And ultimately, the desire of the patron of America's request to St. Juan Diego was to build a church. And as I told them last night, build a church in her honor. And ultimately, where Mary is, there is Jesus. And we are called to build a church, to continuously build a church, our family of faith, and our domestic church, our families. That's what we're called to do, especially today. And so may we work together in asking our Lord to help us to continue to be his hands and feet, to continue to build the blocks that are necessary, not just for our faith, but the faith of our families, our faith of our parish family, our communities. We're constantly called to build up. And so that invitation to St. Juan Diego is continuous even today. And if we keep relying on the Lord, that chapel that she requested to be built, as we know, became a large church, the same thing goes. We place our hearts in the hands of God, and things begin to blossom. With humility, let us bring our needs before God, trusting in his loving care for us. For church leaders, may God grant them wisdom in discerning the Father's will, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. For civic leaders, may the Holy Spirit offer them insight in working for the true and good, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. For those struggling to turn away from sin, may God fill them with his strength, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. For this community of faith, may the Lord grant us the grace to hear his voice more clearly in our Advent preparation, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who have died, may they be welcome into God's presence at the eternal banquet, we pray. For the intention of the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass being offered this morning for Merle Smith, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. God of truth and righteousness, hear our prayers and answer them according to your holy will. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. May the offerings we bring in celebration of St. Lucy win your gracious acceptance, O Lord, we pray, just as the struggle of her suffering and passion was pleasing to you. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy you give ardor to their faith. To their endurance you grant firm resolve. And in their struggle the victory is yours through Christ our Lord. Therefore all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration. And we with all the hosts of angels cry out and without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Giving thanks, you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Ronald, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, of the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ. The 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 body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Let us pray. O God, who bestowed on St. Lucy a crown among the saints for her twofold triumph of virginity and martyrdom, grant, we pray, through the power of this sacrament, that bravely overcoming every evil, we may attain the glory of heaven, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives. Thanks be to God. Saint Michael, Archangel, defend us in the day of battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do that, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Prosit pro nobis singulis.